I got a text earlier in the week from my BFF in Texas. Kat asked me to show her how to make pie dough, gluten-free pie dough. So what I do is I take 1 cup of butter and 8 ounces of cream cheese, and I cube them up because it's easier on the mixer. And I'm going to drop it in the mixer with my blade on. And I'm going to whip these together. The butter and cream cheese has mixed up really well together. And to that, I'm going to add 1/2 teaspoon of sea salt. One half teaspoon of almond extract. One half teaspoon of vanilla extract. And 1 tablespoon of sugar. And I'm going to mix those back up together until it's really smooth. And I'll let you know what it looks like when I finish whipping it up. So I whipped all that together. I'm now going to add 2 1/4 cups of King Arthur gluten-free baking mix. I started with King Arthur. That's how I learned to cook with gluten-free. It was available when I was living in Texas. By the way, the pies in Texas are outstanding. I learned so many new pie recipes. Fall is fast approaching, and I'm really excited about the opportunity of going back and showing you some of those. There was 1 1/4. I'm going to add 1 more cup. I'm going to whip this up together, and then the crucial part of my pie dough comes next. So I have my dough all mixed up in the bowl. I'm going to take 1/2 of it out, because I only want to make a 1/2 a pie, or 1 pie. Because this works out to be 1 pie or 2 pies if you're 1 pie if you're covering your pie, and 2 pies if you're not. Now, what you'll notice here is gluten dough acts differently than regular dough. And right now, this would be a great pie crust, except it's not going to be at all flaky. And we love flaky pie dough crusts. So what I do is I start and I push my dough down, and this is some more of my baking mix. And I take my baking mix and I sprinkle it on top. And I make a nice little layer, dust it off, fold it over, and squish. And I keep doing this, making sure I have enough powder on top, and rolling it over and pushing it back down. Every time you put a flour layer on this dough, you're going to have a flaky layer. So, depending on your mood and how flaky you want your dough crust, depends on how often you work it. Now, if you're working with gluten dough, you would not want to work it this much because it kind of makes it tough and you want to chill it. But this is gluten-free. So, we just keep going along here. I think I'm going to use this pie tomorrow morning and make a pear pie for breakfast. So I'm rather flaky because the pears are very light and delicate. If you do not, you've all probably heard of the Colorado Palisade peaches. Well, Palisade, Colorado is also very famous for their pears. So once I get this dough working here, and you can start to see, if you look at this, the layers, it's forming here. Get it all sent out. Grab my rolling pin. And I'm going to start rolling it out. I find that gluten-free dough is a lot like Play-Doh. You get to play with it. It doesn't hurt it. Makes it actually better. And yes, I am literally going to put this in like clear. I'm just going to work it up to the edges. Just like this. Doesn't take very long, just a little patience. You can see I'm moving the dough at the bottom of my hand to make it smooth and flat. You don't want it too thick on the bottom. Nobody really likes to have a shortbread cookie at the bottom of their pie. Once you get this dough in your pie pan, you can then bake it like this if you wanted to do a cream pie, something cool and light, or you can then fill it and bake it. So here's my finished pie crust. It's ready for my pear pie in the morning. I hope this helps, Kat. Good luck on your business ventures. Good idea on the gluten-free pies. Have a great night.